my soul to thrive. It keeps my dying faith alight. This fruit doth make my It keeps my dying faith alight. It makes my soul
my soul in haste to be with Amen. Go ahead. Greetings, everyone. Welcome to Annapolis Area Christian School commencement of 2022. I know we're just giving them a greeting, but can we, this is a Christian school, so can we give God a hand clap for our kids? Come on. We're going to have our opening prayer. Let's bow our heads. Gracious God, our Father in heaven, we thank you. We thank you for this day, this afternoon, this moment that we're in. We thank you for our students of 2022 who have gathered today, who have made the journey 4 years ago, and today is their day of celebration. And we're so thankful. We know because of your grace, because of your mercy, because of your faithfulness, they are here to stand. And our parents and our grandparents and our friends and well-wishers are here today to rejoice with them. We know for some students, it hasn't been easy. Even for some of our teachers, it could have been easy for them. Even through the pandemic, where things just had to be changed and we had to find a way to still educate our children. But thanks be to God, we have come this far by faith. So we are thankful today. But God, even though we are rejoiced and everyone's here excited for this great day, there are some of us as parents or maybe here with a little moment of pause. Why? Because during the 4 year tenure of their kids being here, maybe they've lost a parent. They've lost a grandparent. They've lost a great friend throughout their course. So Father, we pray for that family member that's lost someone who wish right now, as they're sitting here, I wish my husband could be here. I wish my wife could be here. I wish grandma, granddad could be here to see this day here. Also, God, we pray for those families in Texas who suddenly tragically lost their children. Oh God, as we are here celebrating, someone right now, some families right now in Texas are mourning and saying, I will never see this day for my child. So we pray for them so that we are mindful as we're celebrating that others are not so fortunate as us. But today is a day that we are rejoicing. So God, we thank you. So what we do now is ask you, God, to take your place in this midst. Bless this commencement. Bless this service. All those that will speak and do something, let there be a camaraderie of union and togetherness. Also, Father, we thank you for the faculty. We thank you for the principal, the deans, and all the teachers that invested 4 years into these students to see this day come. So God, we give you thanks and we give you praise. And all the people in this place say amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Wilson. Good afternoon and welcome to Annapolis Area Christian School Commencement Exercises for 2022. My name is Don Wiley and I have the privilege of serving as Academic Dean here. And on behalf of our principal, Cheryl Washington, who became sick yesterday afternoon and evening, wishes she could be here. Just wanted to extend our heartfelt greetings and thank you for making the effort to be here today. We have, it's been a long distance that many of us have traveled and some of us are still finding seats. Thank you for coming in and making room. We do want to go ahead though and open our ceremony today, as usual for graduation, with remarks to welcome you by our class of 2022 salutatorian, Miss Sarah Oley.
To Mr. Edmonds, Mr. Kempton, Dr. Washington, faculty, family, friends, and anyone else who managed to get their hands on coveted graduation tickets, good afternoon and welcome. I promise I'll be brief, since I would inevitably lose at least three of my classmates to sleep otherwise. When Mr. Wiley informed me on Monday, May 16th, that I was most likely the valedictorian, one of the first things I did was ask him if there's any way I could just not be. Turns out dreams come true. Just not in the way I hoped, as I am still speaking to an uncomfortably large amount of people as the salutatorian. To quote comedian John Mulaney, I also do not want me to be doing what I'm doing. Despite public speaking being one of my least favorite things, I am grateful and incredibly humbled to represent the AACS graduating class of 2022. As I thought about how to describe the classmates, friends, teammates, and peers standing behind me, I thought of resilience. Resilience is the ability to stand up to challenges, work through them step by step, and bounce back stronger than you were before, according to Urban Dictionary. As cliche as it sounds, the people standing behind me today make up an unbelievably resilient class. This is a class who has been through it all and has been expected to continue on as if nothing ever happened. We have had immense loss. Loss of sanity at times, loss of normalcy, hope, friendships, and even loss of loved ones. We are a class of fighters. Some have fought depression, and others have battled and overcome hardships against all odds. Every one of us has been knocked down and is standing here today as a testament to our resilience. But we haven't done it alone. Each of you here today has walked alongside us and allowed us to be strong through your own strength. Truth be told, most of us wouldn't be here today without the support we've received. To our teachers, mentors, coaches, parents, friends, siblings, and family, your love and support has brought us through. Your quiet strength, selfless sacrifice, and consistent presence has not gone unnoticed. Thank you. To my parents, despite my stubbornness in admitting this, I'm here because of you. Thank you for being there to help me no matter what. And finally, each of us stands on this stage by the grace of God. Throughout hardships, we've relied on Him, and He has faithfully and graciously delivered us here today. The class of 2022.
Thank you, Sarah. As our salutatorian noted, we are not here by our own efforts solely. We stand on the shoulders of many others, and it's these gathered guests, and particularly parents, whom we want to take a moment right now to honor. Annapolis Area Christian School, its mission says, we engage students in an education of excellence, enabling them to impact the world through a growing relationship with Jesus Christ. And that growing relationship with Jesus Christ began at home and is nourished and cherished and nurtured by you all. And so we're just building on this as partners with you. So we would just want to acknowledge, and this class, the class of 2022, wishes to express their appreciation and gratitude to all parents here today and grandparents as well. At the same time, as Pastor Wilson noted, we want to acknowledge parents who are no longer with us. Please join me in a moment of silence as we once again mourn their passing. Thank you. I'd like to ask the parents of the graduating seniors to stand at this time and to receive the thanks of their sons and daughters. So go ahead, please, find your parents, but back row, stand first. Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, just go. It's okay. Thank you.
out of order.
Good afternoon. My name is Rick Kempton. I have the privilege of serving as the superintendent head of school here at Annapolis Area Christian School. And you just experienced something that is special, those of you that are moms and dads. As your children came down, just this last Monday, I was in Southern California for my granddaughter's high school graduation, and I was watching the emotion that was expressed by you as your kids and grandkids came down to you, and I was with you just a couple of days ago in that same emotion. It's a special day for sure. We have 10 of these graduates who fall into kind of a unique category. We call them lifers. And that only means that they've been here for 13 years. And not because they had to repeat a few along the way, but because they started in kindergarten. And so I think it would be appropriate for us to have those lifers stand and for their parents to stand who have written 13 years worth of tuition checks, which they get to celebrate concluding today. So if you're a lifer, would you stand? And parents of the lifers, would you stand as well, please?
All right, now it's my turn. Also, as a lifer of AACS, my name is Brian Denstead, class of 1997. Hello, parents, family, and friends, honored guests, board members, faculty and staff, and the class of 2022. What's up, guys? You good? Yeah, okay. I was not quite sure on the timing, like how much time I had. I just took a ballpark and figured it had to be in between the 15 and 20 minute mark. So I will make sure I fall under 20 minutes. Promise won't be that long. I have the honor to welcome you into really what is one of the most prestigious clubs in the history of modern day society. Dare I say, the history of humanity. Soon your names will be etched in the stone of greatness along some legends like William Vaughn Writings. That deserves a clap, yes. And I know what you're thinking right now. I can see it, Lane, I can see it on your face. You're thinking to yourself, does life get any better than this? And in the midst of the tempest of emotions that you're feeling right now, you might find this hard to believe, but I'm telling you the truth, Michael, it does get better than this. It does. However, this is a pretty momentous occasion. You're simply going to move from being an AACS student to an AACS alum. And I've heard it said that being welcomed into this club is akin to being elected into the National Football Hall of Fame, or even winning the Masters Golf Tournament. And who am I to disclaim such an honest comparison? However, I don't have a gold jacket to offer you guys. I don't even have a green jacket to offer you. But there is a website you can go to, aacseagles.org/spiritwear, where you can buy yourself a really nice AACS jacket. And I know for a fact that some of you could use an AACS jacket. There were many a cold winter days where you guys would walk into my classroom with your non-uniform jacket and sometimes a blanket. Stanley Boardman, I'm talking to you, sir. I know you're laughing, Sierra and Michaela, but that's also to you as well. I'm going to stop naming names because this could get long. You get the point. Anyway, but let's put all that joking aside and really the reason why I'm up here. Class of 2022, we are here today to celebrate a great achievement, moving from student to this unique club we call AACS Alumni. Access to this club comes as a result of a lot of hard work and sacrifice from you and many people who have supported you over the years. And as you make this exit off of this highway onto another road, please know that wherever you find yourself in life, this place is a place you can return to time and time again to find people who love you, who care about you, admire you, and respect you.
We are proud of you. And we are proud to call you AACS alumni. Class of 2022, welcome to the club.
Thank you, Mr. Denstedt. Mr. Brian Denstedt serves as department head for mathematics and is a beloved math teacher at our school. Next, we'll be hearing from two more student speakers. We have the unique occurrence of double valedictorians this year. So one at a time, we'll be hearing from Ms. Kaylee Brooks and the Ms. Claire Boss. Kaylee?
That was an awkward walk. All right, Mr. Edmonds, Mr. Kempton, Dr. Washington, faculty, family, friends, and most importantly, seniors, good afternoon. If I'm being honest, I had no idea how to start writing this speech. I may have started writing it the evening it was due, which was two nights ago maybe, with no idea how or where to start. So where did I turn? The internet, obviously. The first link that popped up, WikiHow. How to write a valedictorian speech. I thought, perfect, so I started reading it. As I read, I noticed that the article was directed towards a normal graduating class and realized it would be of no help to me, as we are not a normal graduating class. On March 13th, around 2:15 p.m. of the year 2020, our lives were changed forever. We were notified that we would not have 1 week off for spring break, but rather two, due to a little sickness called COVID-19 that was beginning to spread. From that moment on, many of us did not see our friends until sometime junior year or even until senior year this year for those that attended school virtually. As we struggled together through these times, we realized that we were all going through a hard time together. Somehow we made it through, and today we are seated here about to graduate high school as the last class of current grades 9 through 12 to have a normal freshman year. We have missed out on many of the traditional high school experiences, but by the grace of God, we are able to walk across stage today and move on to the next parts of our lives as the world begins to return to normalcy. It's been an interesting senior year for all of us, filled with memories and challenges, and most importantly, gaining knowledge. The three most important things that I have learned this year are, number one, birds aren't real, $20. The earth is flat, and Quizlet has all the answers. In all seriousness, this year has been full of real learning, and we have all learned so much, especially about forming relationships with each other. I have watched bonds form between the most unlikely people who were able to connect due to the pandemic. Some of the strongest bonds between people have been formed or strengthened due to the chaos of our world, which truly shows the Lord at work. Despite the never-ending chaos of this year, I have had amazing support and would like to thank my mom and my dad, my in-school mom, Senora Woody, my friends' moms, who I have adopted as my own, my siblings, and my friends. Look, Mom, I made it. We have come through so much as a class, and it has been a true joy to be a part of this senior class and to share the memories and the laughs we have created, such as the mariachi band the other week. Remember to live, laugh, and love as you continue with your lives. Seniors, as we are together for one last time, let us pause to reflect on our time here, but look with joy to the future and to the amazing paths that the Lord calls each and every one of us to. Congrats, class of 2022. We made it.
Mr. Edmonds, Mr. Kempton, Dr. Washington, faculty, family, and friends, good afternoon. I know that you've already heard from a lot of intelligent blonde girls today, but I think I'm the last one. Nevertheless, I'm excited to say that as a class, we are all here today to graduate and begin the next big chapter in our lives. Throughout these past 4 years, so many things in our lives have changed. We came in as freshmen, most of us having no idea of what to expect of the high school experience. The friends we would make, the trials we would face, how we were going to leave our mark at this school. But throughout our time together, I've seen how much we've grown as a class. Whether it was in the classroom, on the athletic field, the stage, or anywhere else that we've been able to put our gifts on display, we discovered a little bit more about ourselves, our lives, and each other. We've discovered friends and relationships that have become important parts of our lives, as they've helped us navigate our best and our worst times over the past few years. Overall, we've made memories and learned lessons that have given us a lot to remember and be thankful for when we think back on our experiences here at AACS. But now that our time in high school has come to an end, it's time to think about the future. I'm sure most of you are in the same situation as you were 4 years ago, a little scared and unsure about where life is going to take you. Just when we thought we had it all figured out, we'll be starting all over again in a new place with new people and new experiences. And if it's any reassurance, I also have no idea about what I'm going to do with myself going forward. But as our lives start to change and we begin to take on new challenges, I think it's important to remember that what has not changed and will never change is the unconditional love from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the one who will never stop giving comfort and peace to those who ask for it, and will stay faithful to you and his promises. I don't know what's coming next, and neither do you. But the good news is that we don't have to. As the Lord said through Jeremiah, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a hope and a future." The Lord has gotten you here, finally graduating, and off to continue the wonderful plan he has for your future. All the times we thought we wouldn't make it, he brought us through to the other side. So I encourage you, continue to trust in the Lord and never lose faith in the plan he has for your life. And so in closing, to my classmates, I would say, there is so much to look forward to as you go off to college, the workforce, the military, on a gap year, or wherever it is you're going with your life. You are young, intelligent, and talented men and women who have the opportunity to use the gifts the Lord has given you to make a difference in this world. Philippians 4:8 says, "Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things." Now let's not just think about these things. Let's go out and make these things happen. I hope that you continue to stay close to the important people in your life, whether it's a teacher that really had a big impact on you, a friend who has stayed loyal and by your side through the best and worst times, and of course your family, who have loved and supported you, even when I'm sure it wasn't easy. That being said, Mom and Dad, thank you for loving and supporting me my entire life. No matter who I was or what I'd done, you always stayed by my side, and I want you to know that that has meant everything to me, and that I am blessed to have you as my parents. And to my brother, Caleb, thank you for being my best friend. I've always admired and looked up to you, and I'm proud to be your sister. Now, I know I said you weren't going to hear from any more blonde girls, but I think there's room for one more. Taylor Swift once said, "Everything will be all right if we just keep dancing like we're 22. Well, we are the class of 2022, which means that we're going on to do incredible things. And if we can't believe Taylor Swift, who can we believe? Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2022.
Good afternoon. My name is Doug Scheid, and I have the privilege to serve as the chaplain here at AACS. It is my honor to announce the recipient of this year's Timothy Award. The AACS Timothy Award has been established to recognize a graduating senior whose life demonstrates a heart of devotion in his or her relationship with Jesus Christ. This is to be evidenced by a sincere commitment to growth in godly character and in service to others. Paul, in his two letters to a young Timothy, exhorts and encourages the believer to strive for holiness, to seek after and exhibit these traits: patience, gentleness, modesty, self-control, sensitivity, sincerity, a servant's heart, submission, encouragement, kindness, and love. As you can see, it's a prestigious award. The AACS Timothy Award recognizes a graduating senior who exhibits these qualities. In light of this, the class of 2022, as well as the faculty, were asked to nominate a student whom they believe well demonstrated this level of character. And while there are many students in this class who were nominated and whom we might recognize for the qualities described, it is my privilege to announce this year's AACS Timothy Award recipient is Lauren Whitney.
Thank you, Chaplain Scheid. Wanted to take a moment as well at this point in our ceremony to acknowledge the tremendous impact of the faculty of AACS. The upper school faculty, the lower and middle school faculty, they have invested in many of these students from the very short years and over the many years following. And we just wanted to take a moment to give them, and I'll invite you to give them our commendation. Well done. Also wanted to mention in particular, last night at awards night, our own faculty had voted on at the upper school one teacher to receive the Excellence in Teaching Award for 2022, and the recipient was Mr. Brian Denstadt. Next, we will hear testimonies from two members of the senior class, followed by a reading of the class verse.
Hi. Okay, you can hear me. Okay. My name is Kaylee Childs. As you can tell, I'm a senior this year. I've attended AACS since freshman year, and these 4 years have taught me a lot. I'm going to give a short and brief testimony on my faith throughout AACS. I have been a Christian all my life, but my faith was really tested as I went throughout these 4 years. Some of these challenges were very common to all of us, such as the struggles of immense amount of schoolwork, which brought stressors and doubt, or COVID, which took us away from each other and gave us a different look on school society. But some were more personal challenges to me, such as my decreased mental health, which made me question myself and if God really cared, or the fire that took my home away, or a recent loss in the family. All of these have really made me question my faith in Jesus. However, one of the things that kept me going was how faith was instilled here at the school. The thing I learned while being here is that you have to remember that God is faithful and his promises are true, no matter what challenges you have. The truth is, God will not give you anything that you can't handle, and the school really emphasized that while I was here. The devotions during assembly, or just the morning announcements with prayer and Bible verses, really helped me to make sure I spent my time with God. With the struggles that I had and that I went through, I really did forget to spend that time with God, and the fact that the school really made a point to make sure that we gave God our time helped me during these challenges. It was also prominent to me that there were teachers that really cared. I want to shout out Miss Mead, because she was there for me and instilled in me that God will be there through the challenges. She really helped me to see that God will put people in your life that you need, including my friends that I made here. They stuck with me through thick and thin and stood in my corner along with God. It just represents that God is here and he's gonna send you people that will be there too. I encourage you to lean on God and the people he sends for you. There are some people that will support you along with him. It should be mentioned that the school really puts emphasis on the fact that Jesus is here, and we need to have faith that he will help us get through the challenges we have. His promise to never leave us or forsake us is true, even if it doesn't always feel that way. So as we go through college or wherever you're going after this day, I encourage you to continue to rely on God as you go and remember that he's there with you through all the good and bad. AACS has taught me that, and I want you to leave knowing that as well. I pray that you all keep God in your heart and that you all succeed in the ways you would like to after you leave here. Thank you.
Hello there. My name is Dakota Caton, and unless something goes terribly wrong, I'm going to be graduating soon. I just wanted to, for my testimony, share with you all a brief story and how that shaped how I view the world and people as a whole. So on December 11th, 2016, my dad sat me, my brother, and my sister down at our dining room table, and he had some news for us. The news was that our mother had cancer and was in the hospital. And this is very hard news for anyone to hear, especially a seventh grade kid. I remember walking through school the next day in a daze, because my mom was in the hospital with cancer. All of a sudden, math homework didn't seem that important anymore. To cut a long story short, my mom is here today, and she is happy and healthy, and she's the strongest person I know. She's kind and generous to a fault, and one of my true heroes. But throughout her extended hospital stay and her 6 months of chemo, I learned a lot about myself and about the world around me and about the people around me. One of the first things that struck me was just how much everyone from our family and our friends and the school that we were a part of poured out for us in that time. I remember Mr. Miller and Ms. Larson and Ms. Romando giving me extensions on homework and pulling me aside to ask me if I was okay. And I remember the Hansen family coming over multiple times with lasagna. I think we actually still have a lasagna in our freezer in the basement. I promise we'll get to it soon. But throughout all this, I felt so much gratitude, but I also had a question. Why? Why were so many people going so far out of their way to help us? And I can't remember where I heard it, but pretty soon after I started asking myself that question, I heard the parable of the dishonest manager, which is one of the few times in which we're called to emulate someone who's dishonest in the Bible. But this manager, to briefly summarize this parable, he realizes he's about to get fired by his master, this very rich person. So what does he do? He calls in all of his master's debtors and forgives them their debt, because he's going to get fired anyway. There's not much he can do to stop that. But now that he's forgiven all these people these debts, he now has somewhere to go after he's been fired. He's not going to be left out alone. And that's an allegory for our life on Earth, because everyone here and everyone on this planet has been served our eviction notice on Earth. As soon as we are born, we are condemned to die. There's nothing we can do about that. However, unlike the common phrase, we can take things with us. Because there are eternal things here on Earth, and they're sitting right next to you, and right in front of you, and right behind you. Because the eternal things in this room are not the flag, or these diplomas, or these robes, or these clothes, or the cars in the parking lot. They're the people sitting next to us. And that's why so many people poured out so much for us, is because the people were worth so much more than any earthly good. And that's the thing that I want to leave with you today, is that we need to sacrifice everything for the eternal, for the people, because we're going to be with them forever. And forever is a whole awful lot longer than that diploma is going to last. Thank you.
So I know Claire said there'd be no other blonde girls on the stage. Don't worry, it's fake, but I am the last one. So I'm going to be reading the class of 22's class verse, which is James 1, 2 through 4. Count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds. For you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. And let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. Thank you.
Thank you, Anna. It's my privilege to introduce our commencement speaker at this point. Our commencement speaker has sometimes been a person from outside our community, but our students often have appreciated when we hear from one of our own, and that is what's going to happen today. Our commencement speaker for the class of, for the commencement address, exercises of 2022 is senior Bible teacher and upper school chaplain, Mr. Doug Scheid.
Mr. Kempton, Mr. Wiley, Dr. Washington, Mr. Edmonds, members of the board, esteemed colleagues, family members, friends and acquaintances, parents, you who have the most invested up here, and senior class of 2022, greetings. It is before the Lord Jesus Christ that we gather here today at Annapolis Area Christian School to celebrate the accomplishments of these young men and women, but also to exhort them as they begin their next phase of life. Will you pray with me? Father in heaven, you've already been invited, but we do so again. We invite your presence. We invite you to be glorified, and we invite you to bless these young men and women, these seniors. God, we thank you so much for them. We dearly love them. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, seniors, it's already been mentioned. Sarah, I appreciated what you said about resilience. That's a great word. I don't have to tell you that it's been a hard 4 years. Different than almost anybody alive today, different than almost anybody's high school experience who's alive today. But you did it. You came through. You are overcomers. More, you finished strong. I want to stress that. You finished well. You nailed your senior practicum presentations. You knocked senior chapel out of the park. It was one of the best that we can remember in a long time. You had the man, Miko Moo, lead us in worship. That was fantastic. It was a great close to a sometimes hard but a good year. You know, when I think about it, other than cheating to beat my Powder Puff football team, you guys have been a great class. I'm convinced Shatice took steroids before the game, and I'm going to turn her into the PPFL for discipline. I can honestly say that I truly enjoyed teaching you this year. You're a great blessing to me, and just when you guys start to get cool, you up and leave us. Many years ago, one of the best commencement addresses I ever heard was given by Billy Graham, the great Billy Graham. He walked slowly to the podium, an elderly man afflicted with Parkinson's, and he gave a powerful speech. But what I remember most was the way he ended. Full of the Spirit of God, he said, class of 1993, it was a long time ago, commence. That's how he ended, and it was awesome. But it struck me that graduations are called commencements. Not because they are endings, but because they're beginnings. And I know that's been stated, and this might seem obvious to all, but it really struck me at that time that you guys aren't just finishing your time here at AACS. This is an announcement. This is an actual beginning of a new phase of life. Though we know many of you will come back to teach, the beginning of the next phase of your life, military, college work, is about to start. Seniors, today starts a new beginning, and we want to commend you for finishing well, but we want to right now encourage you to begin well. Many will tell you that you're about to enter the real world, and for some reason that phrase has always bothered me. It's not really the real world. There are different challenges, perhaps greater temptations, less protection, but it's not the real world. The real world is where God is honored, where humanity and creation act and live as God intended. And on one level, I guess I can say that that world doesn't exist this side of Christ's return. But on another level, I would argue that the homes you're leaving, the school you attended, this is more the real world than where you're going. And I'm certainly not arguing that your homes are perfect and nor that AACS is. But the different world which you are entering is a broken place, and it's in need that you take what you learned at home and what you learned here at AACS, that you take those things to them. Let me give you an illustration. Years ago, I was sitting in a coffee shop, which I almost always did, and a woman came in with, I think was her daughter. They came in all dressed flamboyantly in crazy attire, and of course, they caught everybody's eye. It was right around Halloween, so they were probably on their way to some sort of a party. And she saw me looking at her, and she saw that I was sitting next to the register, and her daughter went to order, and she came over, and she started talking to me. And it turns out she was Ukrainian. And as I had been to Ukraine a couple of times in my life, we began a conversation. Next thing you know, she sat down. And she saw my open Bible, and she pointed at it, and she says, "Why you read this?" I was taken a little bit aback, and I tried to give her a good intellectual answer. In fact, she asked me a series of questions. All of them, I was kind of on my heels, and I didn't do a great job responding. Finally, she said, "I believe that religion is a crutch for weak people who can't make it in this life." And my first instinct was to defend myself. No, I'm smart. I'm not weak, nor are Christians, et cetera, et cetera. But the Lord stopped me, and he gave me a better word. And I said, "You're right. We're all weak. We're all crippled. And we need this crutch." And she squinted her eyes and looked at me and said, "Good answer, good answer." And the world needs to recognize that we, that you seniors recognize that you can't do it without God. The world needs to see this, that you need Jesus to make it. Seniors, today I want to give you one word that I want you to remember, and if you will remember it and act upon it, it will change the trajectory of your life. And that word is abide. It means to remain, to continue, to dwell. In fact, it almost means, and we're going to use this word, to stay. The word I give you is stay, abide. In John chapter 15, Jesus is speaking to his disciples, and it's the end of his life, near the end of his life. And he's talking to them in what might be considered, after 3 or 4 years of ministry, a graduation speech. They're in the upper room. He's been training them for all these years. And in 6 verses, he uses the word abide 8 times. He says, "Abide in me. Abide in me. Stay in me. Remain in me." Jesus wants you, he wants us to stay in him. As you begin your new phase of life, there are 3 areas in which you are to abide in Christ. And the first one is to stay on your knees, seniors. Be men and women of prayer. When you pray, you are saying to God, "You are God and I am not. I need you." The Bible doesn't suggest that we pray. The Bible commands that we pray. Peter doesn't say, "You should consider casting all your anxieties on him." He commands it. Cast all your anxieties on God because he cares for you. Paul says, "By prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus." And James, in an indicting statement, says, "You have not because you ask not." When my wife and I get busy, we've got 4 little kids. I've got a long commute right now in my life. A ton of things going on at work. What my wife and I need more than anything else, and we try to work at it, and I'm sure everybody in here that's married can relate. What we need more than anything else is time together. And when we do that, our relationship is renewed and it's almost restored in the matter of speaking. And this is the same with the Lord. We need time with Him. Seniors, I can't stress it enough. You need time with Jesus. And we all make excuses about the busyness of life, don't we? We always say, I was going to pray, but I'm so busy. But all of us know that we make time for what's most important, don't we? We all do. If something's important, we make time for it. Seniors, I want to encourage you to make time with the Lord in prayer, the most important thing. But on top of that, you need to be and we need to be, we need to stay in His Word. All of us here. Is it any wonder that when Joshua is about to begin his ministry, he's about to take over leadership from Moses, he's about to take over one of the most important jobs you could possibly have, a leader of a couple of a million people, that the one thing God says to him that you cannot do without is My Word. He says there's one thing that will give you success in what you're about to do. Do not let this book of the law, do not let the Bible depart from your mouth. Meditate on it. Think about it. State it. Recite it. Stay in His Word. And this is why we abide, because we have a God that wants to talk to us and wants to hear from us. And the last area where you need to abide, and this may sound a bit strange, is in the name. Abide in His name. Call on it. Speak it. Do not be ashamed of the name Jesus Christ. Call on the name that is above every other name. Do you ever wonder why it is that name that is used as a curse word? You ever ponder that? The name Jesus Christ. When people are surprised or angry, they say, Jesus Christ. They express it. There are plenty of other great men and women out there. Why His name? Why His name? You never hear someone surprised say, Abraham Lincoln. You never hear it, right? But when you're angry with your son, you don't say Mahatma Gandhi. You don't do it. Why Jesus? Why Jesus? There's sort of a perverse glory there, isn't there? I know of a man who came to Christ because he heard people cursing the name, and he thought there has to be something to this. Everyone knows that name is different. No matter how hard we try to trivialize it, no matter how much we may want to, that name is different. Years ago, I was on my honeymoon. We were in Aruba, and there was a certain floor in the hotel where we were staying where you could go and get smoothies and treats for free. Needless to say, I visited that floor frequently. And you developed casual conversation and casual friendships with the people who were staying there at the time. And it came up that I knew who Todd Beamer was, that not only did I know who Todd Beamer was, but that Todd Beamer and I were friends. I'm not sure how many of you know that name, but Todd Beamer is one of the men who on Flight 93 fought against the terrorists, spoke to the operator, called on the name of Jesus, and then attacked the terrorists and the plane went down. He's a hero, there's no doubt about it. This guy was blown away by the fact that Todd Beamer was my roommate. In fact, he couldn't quite bring himself to believe it. He pulled me aside and sat me down and began to ask me about Todd Beamer. He was in awe. And if I had had my wits about me, I might have said, I know someone a lot greater than Todd, but I wasn't thinking that way at that time. But the name Todd Beamer meant something. And I want to argue to you and I want to tell you that we are called Christians for a reason. We bear the name of Jesus Christ. You bear it. We bear it. This is the name that at the end of time, before whom every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Remember that. Abide in that name. So to abide is to depend. It's to recognize that you are not God and that you desperately need Him, seniors. And I think I can state with confidence that every single one of us in this room desperately needs Him. None of us can make it without Jesus. Class of 2022, you will never make it without Jesus. So I say, stay on your knees, stay in His Word, and stay in His name. Senior class of 2022, I exhort you and I charge you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Abide. Thank you.
You know, Doug Scheid is not just our chaplain and our senior Bible teacher, but he's also the head basketball coach. So I think it's appropriate that he was the commencement speaker while we do this in the gym, because we know that basketball is talked about in the Bible, entering the courts with praise. And we got to do that. So thank you, Doug. Well, in just a minute, I'm gonna be a part of why we all came today, and that will be the opportunity for our graduates to receive their diploma. But first, there's a small group in our school community that is elected by our school community. It's called our school board. And those are people that kind of oversee the policies and the practices of our school system and pretty much work behind the scenes and don't get an opportunity to be thanked very often. And I know a number of them are with us today. There are 12. Not all of them were able to be here. But if you are one of the members of our school board, our Board of Education, would you please stand so that we can thank you for what you've done for us. Well, it's my privilege now to do what I indicated earlier. It's a privilege for me to confirm to you and to confirm to the president of our school board, Mr. Michael Edmonds, that every single one of our seniors here have completed the requirements required by the state of Maryland and our Board of Education to earn their diplomas today. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I give to you the class of 22.
For each graduate, we will read the name printed on their diploma, followed by their senior practicum topic. Honors designation will be highlighted as appropriate. Seniors, prepare for the reception of your diploma. Mason Cole Allred, substance abuse, dualism, and the soul. Grayson Moore Anders, how God calls Christians to respond to the pro-choice argument. Carolyn Mary Anderson, how missing parents growing up may affect childhood. Kelly Louisa Atkinson, psychological abuse in young adults. Stephen Ora Barger, inclusion in the church for the neurodivergent. Kate Summer Barlock, cultivating the Christian worldview in a secular society, with honors. Julia Abigail Berger, the long-term effects of domestic abuse on women. Leah Joanne Boardman, unbiblical divorce, with honors. Robert Stanley Boardman, happiness over wealth in the United States job market. Christopher Andrew Bollinger, the problems of mass incarceration in America.
Claire Michelle Boss, the lack of special education programs in Christian schools, with honors. Kaylee Grace Brooks, child sex trafficking in the United States. Ashley Nicole Brown, the lack of education surrounding skin cancer in youth. Kaylin Olivia Paris Brown, mental health illness in the African American community. William Fitzgerald Burton, the misconceptions of epilepsy. Kaylee Reagan Carnell, misrepresentation of mental health in films. Gabriel Michael Kerrigan, the harmful experiences of Hispanic immigrants. Dakota Michael Caton, the lack of medical training in schools. Kaylee Elizabeth Childs, autism stereotypes, the impact and disconnect they create, with honors. Gavin Charles Cho, the rise of lukewarm Christianity.
Lily Elizabeth Clausen, the mistreatment of female athletes in the sports industry. Nathaniel Craig Klingscale, mistreatment of animals. Kevin Edward Colas, sleep and rest deprivation. Nolan Alexander Cote, caring for the environment. Abigail Elizabeth Marie Crosby, rape. What are the long-term effects of it on women? Madeline Sophia DeVries, fast fashion. Ryan William Dickerson, how COVID-19 impacted people's mental health. Brandon Jehaziel Farquharson, finding reconciliation. Kylie Elizabeth Fenn, illiteracy in Nicaragua. Kamal Amadi Farrell, food waste in schools.
Donnie Tamarik Frayer, mass incarceration. Georgia Kennedy Garner, how school affects the mental health of students. Caleb Robert Gentry, bad physical health in teens. Alyssa Kiara Nicole Gilmore, violence against Indigenous women. Sarah Lois Graustein, creativity in the classroom with honors. Trevor Anthony Gray, fix the financial gap. Christopher Jaden Green, incarceration and mental health. Lydia Mary Guercio, bullying in schools. Haley Abigail Guerrier, political polarization in America. Olivia Virginia Hall, Low Self-Esteem and Teenage Girls. Madison Barbara Holler, Animal Abuse.
Augustus John Hammond, Biogas for the Future in Motor Transportation. Jonathan Corey Hardy, Teachers Attending to the Mental Health of Students, with honors. Joshua Corey's Hardy, The Lack of Attention to Athletes' Mental Health. Braden Leah Marie Heckert, The Negative Effects of Distance Learning in Children with Special Needs During the COVID-19 Pandemic. Owen Robert Heiser, Why Kids Should Spend More Time Outside. William Thomas Henderson, The Importance of Mental Health in Athletes. Jackson Lee Hornberger, World Hunger. Ashby Kendall Irvin, Stigma of Mental Health and Trauma. Geriani Mickens Jean-Baptiste, Climate Change and Its Impact on Society. Sydney Deborah Irene Jennings, Poverty in America.
Alyssa Renee Johnson, Broken Relationships Between Parents and Teachers, with honors. Leslie Grace Kelly, The Negative Effects of COVID-19 on the Physical and Mental Health of Healthcare Workers. Mikayo Wesley Collette, Resolving the Conflict Between Science and Religion. Mia Nicole Langley, The Prevalence of Distracted Driving. Josie Marie Liga, The Negative Effects of Long-Term Foster Care. Jacob Daniel Litz, Creating Good Christian Art. Paige Elizabeth Lovelace, The Israeli-Palestinian Conflict, with honors. Riley Christian Lowry, The Effects of COVID-19 on Student Athletes Receiving Scholarships for College. Daniel Mancia, Dealing with Religious Persecution and Harassment in Afghanistan. Jackson Edward Martin, The Stigma Surrounding Mental Illness.
Michaela Alexis Martin, Systemic Racism in America, with honors. Annalise Eileen McHugh, Suicide and Self-Harm in Youth. Heather Flora McLeod, Anxiety in High Schools, with honors. Molly Jane Meinsler, Environmental Justice. Michael Christopher Moritz, Ocean Pollution. Noah Andrew Marotti, Elder Abuse, An Overlooked Issue. Xiaozhu Mo, the visual arts in daily life. Alexandra Jane Murphy, how the lack of arts education affects students academically, mentally, and socially. Shannon Elizabeth O'Farrell, establishing boundaries and making healthy relationships with honors. Sarah Elizabeth Ole, restoring the church's relationship with the LGBTQ community with honors.
Grace Catherine Raspa, the importance of Christian mentoring for teens. Paige Lynn Rice, helping children without families. Lane Margie Rogers, accommodating students with ADHD. Tatiana Sierra St. James, the negative effects of the foster care system. Troy Dominic Sarchapone, food insecurity in people with food allergies. Shatice Kalia Shabazz, the victimization of people with mental and physical disabilities with honors. Hannah Tatiana Sheldon, responding to animal abuse. Colby Marshall Renee Smith, the digital danger zone. Spencer Aaron Stein, bullying and how it affects kids. McKenna Corinne Steinau, reducing the stigma surrounding autism.
James Lawrence Tashoff, inequalities disabled people face. Natalie Ann Truelove, plastic pollution. Joshua Mark Vasquez, God being taken out of society. Sierra Monet Venable, mental health in veterans. Philip Andrew Scott Venkatesan, ethics of human genome editing with honors. Amanda Elisha Vincent, the lack of diverse history education and how it continues to white supremacy. Jenna Ann Vossler, why public schools do not adequately prepare kids for the real world. Thomas Lawrence Waldron, genetic engineering, an increasing problem in God's world. Avery J. Walker, social media and its negative effects on the teen psyche. Penguin Wong, leadership.
Perez Reese Warner, the decrease of biblical interest in teens and young adults. Daniel Scott Whaley, students who struggle to connect to school communities with honors. Yeah. Lauren Ruth Ann Whitney, African Poverty. Daniel Joseph Williams, How Teachers Can Help Students Who Struggle with ADHD. Ava Yasara Wilson, Gender Equalities and Executive Leadership with Honors. Samuel Charles Woody, How Christians Should Approach the Political Divide in America with Honors. Nathaniel Francis Roble, Space Exploration. Jabari Khalil Young, The Effects of Littering. May I present to you the class, the graduated class of 2022.
Well done, graduates. Congratulations again, the class of 2022. Go ahead and take your seats. Go ahead and take your seats. As we are not... As we prepare for our recessional, as we prepare for our recessional, that's our exit, we'd like to ask our audience to remain seated while the graduates, until the graduates finish processing. And now I'd like to invite Pastor David Whitney out to the podium for closing prayer.
Thank you. Let us join together in prayer. God, our Father, we thank you that we can come into your presence this day of great celebration. We thank you, Father, for the sons and daughters that you have graciously entrusted to us these past 18 years. We know that you gave them to us to raise in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. We dedicated these sons and daughters 18 years ago to you that they might come to faith in Christ, repenting of their sins, believing all that the Word of God says as absolute truth, and receiving Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. We took what you have taught us from your holy word, and we have entrusted it to them. We desire that they go the distance, that they endure to the end as faithful, unshakable disciples of our Lord Jesus Christ. We're reminded of what the psalmist said, "Lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are the children of the youth. Happy is the man that hath his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate." Father, we have carefully prepared them for this day, just as an expert archer would check the fletching and the shaft and the point of the arrow, so we have been about this task for some time now. And today, dear Lord, as we have now taken them out of the quiver, and as with an arrow we have placed the nock of the arrow into the nock point of the bowstring, we have with the strength of our arms drawn back that bow to full position, taken very careful aim at the target, drawn in a deep breath as we readied ourselves for that moment in time when the full force of the bow would be transmitted to that arrow, launching them with great force towards the bullseye to which we have aimed. And Father, we are aiming these arrows, our sons and our daughters, at the bullseye labeled the glory of God. Father, we pray today that as we release our sons and daughters, these precious ones, that they would go out into this world with the light and the glory of Christ shining through them. We pray that their lives would make an indelible impact for the kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray that they would accurately hit that target, that their lives might be lived unto the glory of God. These things we ask and we pray in the holy and blessed name of your dear Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And God's people said together, amen.